Welcome back to Equipped to Endure. I am Rusty.
And I'm Chris.
And we're really excited about the video that we are shooting for you right now. So we did a mountain house video not too long ago that got a ton of comments, and these really fell into two main camps. The first being, hey, you really need to compare mountain house against my Patriot Supply or Alpine Air or whatever, all these different brands. And we're planning on doing that. So that will be a future video. But there was another comment we got a lot of.
The biggest comment was, hey, have we tried different flavors of Mountain House, like the homestyle chicken noodle casserole or the chicken fried rice?
Chili Mac was a popular one.
Chili Mac or the lasagna and the spaghetti. And so we reached out to Mountain House.
No, Mountain House reached out to us. We did not reach out to Mountain House. So yeah, we got accused a lot for being biased in there. We bought that stuff with our own money because we were curious people. But they reached out and they said, hey, we want to partner with you. And we said, okay, which one of our kids do you want in order to make that happen? They didn't take our kids, but they did send us food, and we recommended this. We said, hey, this would make for a really cool video. Send us one of everything that you make so that we can taste test it and basically let you do a vicarious taste testing of their whole product line, and they're in. So big thank you to Mountain House for sending that out. And another big thank you, it's pretty hard to find this stuff sometimes in your local Costco or even at Walmart, and it's even harder to find a discount on it. But they offered all E2E viewers and subscribers 10% off. We're going to put that coupon code first thing down in the description so you can check it out. And that way you can get your supply and get 10% off and hopefully be able to get some of these varieties that are on the board. Okay, so our approach for the video, how do we decide to grade each one of these as we try it?
Well, a couple things for the approach. One thing we've noticed, just to kind of, you know, some housekeeping stuff right here. You got the yellow, which are basically the breakfast entrees. You have the orange, which are just your main meals. Then you have this Pro Pack over here, which are kind of your high caloric meals, and they also coincide with some of the orange meals. And then you have your fuchsia, pink, however you want to slice it, and these are your desserts. So we're going to open them up, we're going to look inside them, we're going to cook them, and we're going to taste them. And we've rated them, Rusty came up with an ingenious plan of 1 through 5. And so I think 1 is going to be, I would not spend my money on this. And then 5 would be, I'd take it on a camping trip.
With that, we're going to go ahead and get started. We're probably going to have to do these in batches. Now, a lot of you may be, you know, serious backpackers and really into this and found this video that way. So one thing we're excited about is we're going to compare. Where did our spaghetti one go, Chris? Where is it?
Right here.
Okay. So the Pro Pack is basically a more calorically dense, maybe more protein. I mean, it'll tell you on the back of the pack, but it's basically a souped up version. Now, we don't want to say souped. It's an amped up version of the normal kit. So this is going to be your normal spaghetti, and this is the Pro Pack and intended for, and don't they say somewhere on here it was intended for more like military type guys?
Well, I just said it met the standards of long range military patrols, whatever that is, but it's basically high caloric food. So if you are out doing adventures, that's an option.
And so if you've ever been curious how these compare, we're going to do that. So we're going to compare the regular versus the Pro Pack. And one more thing, let's talk about sodium for just a second. Another comment that seemed to show up a lot in the comments on the other video was, man, those meals have so much salt in them. They do. One of the things that they say, it's almost like Gatorade, right? It's intended to replenish electrolytes and sodium when you're on the trail, when you're spending a lot of energy and sweating a lot. Now, for that reason, again, we're not nutritionists, so we can't tell you this, but you may not want to eat this for every meal for a year. But when you're going out, you're on the trail, you're working out a lot, this is going to be good for you.
Yeah.
Is that fair to say?
That's fair to say. And then so I guess maybe the last thing people want to know is like, how much of this should I buy?
Uh-huh.
And so kind of we recommend probably a week supply per person would be a good starting number. We look at this, or I look at this as, you know, something you'd grab if a natural disaster happened, or you just need to get out of your house and you need to leave home. These are easy to transport. You really can't break them. You just have to add water. And then, like we did in the last video, once you cook them, you just can throw away the bags. So they're pretty clean.
With all that said,
let's do this.
Let's dig in. So, just in case you haven't seen how this works before, we're going to start. Where's our Southwest one? You wanted to try this one, right? Okay. When you open the pack, you just grab these nice little terrible tabs, open it up, and before you do this, whoop, you make sure that you are getting the right amount of water. It will tell you how much water to put in each one. Now, a lot of people in the comments were saying, yeah, always put less water than what they say. That hasn't been my experience.
It has been mine.
So maybe it's the altitude. We're up in the mountains and it's dry where we're at.
Just a reminder, you definitely want to pull the oxygen tab out. So
Yep. They say, I've actually read a little thing about this. It won't necessarily hurt you, but yeah, take it out.
Yeah, we just want to just like cook it.
Well, yeah, it won't hurt you if you take it out. I guess if you eat it, it could do some damage, but that's what a freeze-dried meal looks like. Just basically crunchy with no water in there. That's the deal. So these are nice and easy to make. You want to do the honors there, Chris?
Yeah, so how much are we pouring into this one?
That whole thing. That's already measured out.
1.5 cups. I'm double checking. 1.5 cups. Okay.
Boiling water.
Let's do it. Okay. So you basically pour it in, and then you seal it, and you let it rest for 10 or so minutes, and it'll tell you on the package.
Now, I think, I'm not sure if these are Mylar. I think it's Mylar, a similar material. But the point is, on the inside, the lining, it traps the heat in there, and it cooks it. So this is a self-contained cooking unit and eating unit.
Yeah, so add the water, stir carefully, close the zipper, wait 5 minutes, stir again, and reseal. Let stand for an additional 4 minutes. So you're looking about 10 minutes.
Now, for stirring, the way that I've liked to do it in the past is I just kind of do this on the outside. You know, oh, do you remember the, what was it? Hamburger Helper? You remember that?
Yeah, I remember that.
Can I stir it like that? Anyway, there we go. Wait 5 minutes.
Yeah.
Okay.
So we're going to go ahead and we wanted to show you how that works, but we're going to go ahead and do all these so we can just speed up the process for the taste test.
Welcome back. These have all been cooked. Now, interestingly enough, people were raving about the biscuits. They were saying, I don't know how Mountain House does it, but those biscuits don't fall apart. They're actually good. So when we opened it up, it was almost like croutons in there. So we'll see how it turned out. So let's start with this guy.
All right.
All right. Now, real quick, as I'm doing this, if you are a backpacker or if you are interested in using these, one of the complaints is when you open these up, and if you're trying to use like a normal like spork, something like this, reaching down in there, you can get food on the inside of your hand. It kind of gets dirty and grimy. It's not very pleasant. There's a couple solutions for this. Some people, you may have seen these on Amazon or bought one yourself, but they have these extra long spoons or forks, whatever, that you can get down in the bottom without having to worry about getting it messy. What I like doing is I'll actually just take my knife and then I'll just run a quick cut right across this. Should I do it real quick? I don't want to make a mess.
Yeah, let's not make a mess.
All right.
We'll get the idea.
You get the idea. I just cut it down, and then it turns into almost a bowl. So that's my approach to it. All right, here we go. So real quick on this is a little runnier than I'm used to when I'm out, and I'm wondering if that's because it's in kind of a warmer environment. It's not out in the cold. And, you know, whatever. But
it's the gravy of the biscuits, man.
It's the gravy. All right. Okay, this is nice and steered up. Let me actually put this right here. All right, bowl, please. Scalpel. Boom.
There you got some dumplings in there, yeah.
It's not such a dumpling.
You only gave me that much.
Because we've got to eat 31 of these, Chris.
That's a good
point. Do you want more?
No, I'm good.
All right. Get in on this.
That is pretty good.
I will say that
you can actually taste the biscuits. It actually tastes like dry brisket in there.
Dry brisket, dude.
Dry biscuit.
All right, here we go.
Pretty good, dude. I would definitely take that backpacking. And the sausage.
Mmm. That was something that is big about Mountain House. They actually use real meat in their food. Guys, if you're going to complain about us talking with our mouth full, you're going to have to get over it because this whole video is going to be full of it, okay?
Yeah. All right, that's good. I actually really like that one. That's really good.
All right, so 5 being like, man, that was amazing.
I'd take it. I'd give it 5. That's just, I mean, that's legit.
Really?
It was legit.
Okay.
So,
on our scale, let's see, that was biscuits and gravy.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Chris, you're giving it a 5.
I'm giving it a 5. I'm not even messing around.
I think I would give it one is I wouldn't even eat it. I'd feed it to the dogs or the wildlife. 5 is really, really good. Dude, you're anxious.
Okay, let's just do this, man.
I think I'm going to give that a 3. That was meh for me.
All right.
I'm going 3.
So you would not buy that? You wouldn't buy it and take it backpacking?
Well, that's not the scale.
Well, I'd take it back.
I'll go 3.5. I'll go 3.5.
Whatever.
It was good.
All right, next one. Spicy Southwest style skillet. So, there you go.
And this is supposed to be a breakfast?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
You can taste the potatoes in there, like crunchy potatoes. It's good.
Real quick, let's take just a second to talk about the biscuits and gravy then. So I think the gravy was really good. The biscuit was good, too. It held together. Mm-hmm. The sausage was not that great for me. That might have been what knocked it a little bit. Any other sort of texture, taste things that you'd want to comment on? It was like a creamy gravy. It tasted good.
Yeah, but at the end of the day, it's camp food.
Yeah.
So it was pretty dang good.
All right, texture on this right off the bat. This is what it looks like. Oh, did we show them inside the bag? Here you go. That's what it looks like.
Hold back here.
Right there. There you go. Here's in the bowl if you want that angle.
Yeah, that's you can taste the potatoes, the crunchy. It's like almost like a skillet of potatoes, like shredded potatoes.
Yeah. They're supposed to be like hash browns.
Yeah, it's hash browns in there. It's pretty good.
At first, almost look like
it's pretty spicy too.
Chips or something.
Kids might not want to eat this, but I think adults would enjoy it. It's pretty spicy.
I'll say that. This is way too spicy for my kids. I like spice, but they would not eat this.
Yeah, I thought it was good, though. I like that one. I'd say a 4. I'd buy it and take it, though.
You like the biscuits better than that?
Yeah. Dude, I like biscuits and gravy, though. It's an army thing.
That's pretty good. I'll actually go... I'll go 4.5 on this.
Yeah, it's the spicy. Okay, we're going to try granola, and then we're going to compare these Pro Packs with the normal version. So... It's granola.
Wait, we're cross-pollinating our flavors here.
That would be good.
All right, 5 is... I would buy that. I would love eating it. That's pretty tasty. I'll go 4.5 on that one.
Right. You just like it because it's spicy, huh?
I do like spice. Okay, which one was that? That was the...
So that was the...
Spicy Southwest.
All right, let's try this granola. Blueberry granola, it looks like.
Spicy Southwest. Where is that on the list? That might not have made it on the list here.
So blueberry granola. I don't know if I would take this. I mean, it's all right. I don't know if I'd take it camping.
Okay, this is the blueberries. I mean,
it's got a decent flavor, but... I'd way more rather have those other two.
Where is it? I want to show a picture of it.
Right here.
Okay, here we go. All right. You didn't already display it, did you?
Not yet.
Okay, it's going to be kind of hard to see.
There you go. It looks like
right in there.
Granola.
Okay.
I mean, it's... I'd rather have, like... If you handed me this for breakfast, I'd rather have the... Unless you said it was a snack.
Well, again, if you like blueberries and if you like granola...
Which I like both of. But I still think I'd rather have the that skillet or the biscuits and gravy.
Yeah, I'm trying to compare it for what the food item is, though.
Yeah. I'm trying to compare it for what I'd buy when I go out.
All right, apparently we're working on different scales here.
It's Rusty's scale. That's 1 through 5.
That tastes like real food.
It is real food.
The blueberries are good. Mm. I think there was even supposed to be like a cream element in that. That's good. For what that is, I'm going to reserve my 5. I'm keeping that one in the pocket. I'll go 4.5 on that.
Really?
Yeah, where are you on it?
I mean, for what it is, it's, I mean, probably a 4. I'm going to go on, would I buy this again, spend my own money on it? I'd probably say a 2.
What?
Yeah.
All right.
Okay. My scale's different.
Okay.
All right, so let's try scrambled eggs. This one's going to be interesting.
But if you were a blueberry granola lover...
Which I am.
And if you want it on the trail, and that's your scale, would you want this? Would you give it? You said 4?
I mean, maybe a 4. So this one's interesting. We got scrambled eggs here. And if you can see, it's pretty runny still, and we put the right amount of water in it. So they're kind of runny.
That could just be a function of a controlled environment.
Yeah, I know, but I'm already getting scared of it.
Let's stir it up a little.
Okay.
All right. Oh, that's way runny. How much water did it say? Add 1 cup.
Did you have
that's way runny. I might have messed up on this one.
All right, we'll forgive you.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, the eggs, I mean, they stayed constituted in the ham in there too, but there's too much water in there.
Can I scoop some out?
Yeah.
I mean, but just from the way it looks right now, I'd probably pass on that.
That's probably user error. My bad. Because when you pull it out, it looks pretty good.
I don't need that much.
When you pull it out, it looks good. That looks like eggs.
Yeah, some? I mean, it looks like eggs there. Okay, let's see what it is.
Did you already show the picture to the camera?
Yeah.
Here, I'll do it again.
So it's interesting. It's eggs.
It's a little runny.
It doesn't seem like it cooked all the way through, though. Really? Like, it's still a little dry in the middle.
And we gave it more time than it recommended, right?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
But, I mean, it's eggs. I mean, I don't know. So it tastes like eggs with bacon, right? But would I take it camping? I mean...
Would you rather have this?
I'd rather have those. Eggs I'd rather have those first two. Bacon. I'd rather have the first two. I mean, they're not bad. It is a variety. I mean, they're trying to give you a variety.
All right, for what it is, I think it's got a really good flavor. The only thing that throws it off for me is the texture a little bit.
Yeah, I mean, I agree. The flavor's actually good. It's got that smokiness. Mm-hmm. It tastes like it's like cooked over a campfire.
Mm-hmm. So. For what it is, eggs and bacon, that score. I think it tastes just as good as eggs and bacon I would actually make.
So after this shoot, if we put this upstairs in your fridge like you talked about, would you eat it?
If I was busy, yeah.
All right.
For what it is, assuming that there was user error on my part, I'd probably go 3.5 on it. Does that sound right?
Yeah, I mean it's good. It tastes campy.
Oh.
We gotta try the other one.
Yeah.
But yeah, at the same time, I'm like, I still like those first two better. And that skillet one, that
the scramble skillet.
Yeah, that one was like you could do that all day.
Yeah. That's pretty
so cool. Hey, same thing on this one. So it's still runny.
Hey, what did you give the eggs and bacon?
I'd say 2.5.
Yeah, you know what? I think I'm modifying mine to 3. Okay,
so it's still running on this one, so that's interesting. And this one was asking for a cup of water also. So let's taste. I mean, I'm assuming they're going to probably
here,
taste
let me stir
same.
It up a little bit.
Yeah.
Okay, did you already show
this Yeah, one? I did.
All right, so yeah, it looks very similar. I'm curious what the difference is going to be.
I mean, it's a good flavor. I mean, it was a good flavor. That smokiness was kind of cool. All
right. So we'll serve you up. No, can you put your bowl over here, please? Right. It's going to be blueberry flavored eggs.
Then. That's fine. So same issue, it didn't get all the way in. Has it fully reconstituted?
So this is the Pro Pack. So we're curious if there's going to be a noticeable difference between the regular, or is the regular? Okay, the regular scrambled eggs and the Pro Pack. So that's what we're looking at right now.
So I think the regular one for me tastes better. Really? I mean, but then again, the Pro Pack is probably, I mean, it's packing with some caloric stuff. Uncured bacon doesn't have that smoky taste. Doesn't really have a bacony taste either, does it?
Yeah, you're right. I was wondering what the difference would be there with the uncured versus cured. Yeah, I like the other one better.
Yeah.
Taste-wise. Yeah. But.
But it has the same texture.
Nutritionally, this one is it the same serving size?
Yeah, I mean, you're going full package, 350 calories, all the way up to 410. I mean, it's there. And then it's a little bit, I think, I'm imagining it's a little bit more weight. But, I mean, there's the, it's obviously meeting some standard, right? Long range, military, whatever. So.
All right, so. Yeah, I like the first one better, too.
Yeah.
With the cured bacon, I have more of that smoky taste in there.
Okay, so what are you giving this one, Chris?
Probably the same. I mean, I would, if you were going to hand me one, I'd rather have the other one. So what I do, 2.5? So I'd probably go 2.
Yeah, I think I'm right there with you. I'm going to go 2.
I'm going to move these out. That spicy skillet's still pretty good, though.
Well, no, 2's low. Because that's getting to the spot where you're like, no, I wouldn't feed that to the animals. I'm going 2.5 on that.
All right.
Would I eat it if it was put in front of me on the trail? Yeah. Would I prefer something else? Yeah, probably, but it's still eatable. That's where I'm at on it. Does that sound fair?
That's fair. Okay, so breakfast skillet. It looks like a breakfast skillet.
And that's this other one too, right?
Yeah, they're both it. So it's actually pretty good. You can see the...
You do a shot again?
Yeah, you can see the sausage, scrambled eggs in there, and you can see the onions and potatoes. So let's try that one. I'll serve that one up.
Stir it up a bit. Oh, yeah, that's much better constituted there. That's not nearly as runny. I wonder if that's just the thing with the eggs and bacon, if it's maybe runnier.
It might just need longer to sit.
Okay, here we go, ready?
Yeah.
That looks good. We got that
potatoes. Yeah, so then would you pick one over the... yeah, this one.
Well, I'm not trying to compare it to itself.
So the eggs in this one are better. And so either they constitute better. It's got a better flavor, too, with all the sausage in there. So I'd definitely take the breakfast skillet over the regular eggs any day. If you're going to buy them, I'd just buy the breakfast skillet. Because it's got the potatoes in there, the sausage. Unless you can't eat meat.
Yeah, the bell pepper in there, the potato, that definitely makes it feel heartier. Mm-hmm. That's a good taste. Yeah, I'd go
pretty good, huh? Not bad.
For what it is? I'm a perfectly round 3.75 on that.
I'd go 3.5, yeah. I mean, it's good.
I mean, okay, which one was that?
Breakfast skillet.
Breakfast skillet.
Let's regular.
Pro pack now.
Oh.
Okay, so I'm 2.75. Wait, no, 3.75. And you said 3.5?
I was going to go 2.75 on that.
Really?
Since you said 3.75. Anyway, no, I'm saying I'd do probably about 3.5.
Okay.
So.
Smart aleck.
There we go. I'm just double dipped. Oh, well. Okay, here we go. Let's try this one.
I think we're taking too big of portions, man. We got to get through 31 of these.
All right. We haven't eaten one. Okay.
Okay. In case you didn't see that shot already.
Yeah, same thing. And the eggs haven't reconstituted all the way.
In its defense, though, they still taste like good eggs.
Yeah, they're good. I can't tell the difference between these two. So in that case, I'd probably take the higher caloric version. The eggs are getting better.
It's just because they're sitting longer. How much time does it say to let them sit on the eggs?
Where's the egg on?
Eggs and bacon right here. Done. And then scrambled egg.
5 minutes and then an additional 4 minutes.
Yeah, and we let it go for over double that.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's good.
I mean, it's not in the freezing cold either.
That's actually a pretty good one. What do you think? I mean, that was a good flavor. I like that one. I mean, between the three, I think we just did, the spicy skillet, biscuits and gravy, and then this breakfast skillet. It's pretty good. I'm going to try the biscuits and gravy again.
Maybe just because I have another bite.
See if I can go back to it.
Biscuits and gravy, yeah.
See if I would do it. Let's see. Okay, so now it's way more creamy. I'm looking for you to put this up in your...
You want me to bump up the score? Yeah, that thickened up, didn't it? Okay.
That's freaking like good. That's pretty good, dude.
All right, you're not having more of this, are you?
No.
Okay,
I mean, we got all this to go through, but... Taste it, see. I don't know if you like... It's pretty good.
It's pretty good. What did I give it last time? I gave it a 3.5. Maybe I was too harsh.
Yeah, you probably go up to 4. Anyway, all right, this was the breakfast. We've wrapped it up. We've knocked everything out. And we'll get cleaned up and start with lunch entrees.
Next up we're doing entrees, and we got several more.
Okay.
Welcome back for round 2. We're doing more entrees. We're excited to try some of these out. I know that I love the Alfredo. The lasagna turned up more than once in the comments on the last video. That's one that we need to try.
So yeah, chicken fajita bowl looks good.
Chicken fajita bowl. So we're just going to work our way down the line here. Let's give it a try.
All right, beef stew.
Beef stew. This looks soupy, which I imagine beef stew should. Now, to be honest, that doesn't look that appetizing to me. But we'll try it out.
Looks like beef stew. Let's show the.
Yeah, I just did there. Do it again.
Right here.
Oh, right here. Boom. You got that in shot? All right, that's what it looks like. Okay. We'll serve it up with this guy. I got to go easy on the portions if we're going to get through all of these. Okay. There's one.
Looks pretty like a lot of food. It looks legit.
Yeah, it should be a decent meal. All
right. We got the chunks of beef.
Chunked out.
Oh, yeah. That's not bad. It's pretty good.
Those potatoes are a lot softer than I thought they'd be.
And the peas. It's definitely beef stew.
That is good.
Mm-hmm.
pretty good. Okay, if I were to take these same ingredients and try to make the same thing at home, well, now let me rephrase that. A decent meal using the same ingredients, I'd probably go 4 on that.
Yeah, I'd say 4. It's good. Okay, it's good to definitely take it on a camping trip.
All right, so we're beef stew. We both give it a 4. 4.
All right, chicken teriyaki.
Chicken teriyaki.
Oh, yeah, this one looks pretty good. It's nice. It's got the rice going. So
yeah, it's saucy.
Yeah, it looks saucy.
Got to stir that junk up.
I can smell it.
Yeah, it does have that ginger scent in there that you get with teriyaki.
Yep.
All right, here's your bowl. Ba-bam. We know that there's going to be a little taste runoff from one to the other.
Wow, that's got some ginger in it. Wow.
This isn't scientific. All right, you already showed it. There it is again, in case you didn't see it. Ba-bam.
It's pretty good. It's got a little ginger kick.
Let me try. I'm going to try a piece of that chicken in isolation here. So with the freeze dried, the meat's obviously going to have a little bit different of a texture rather than if you just took a chicken breast out and, you know, barbecued it. But even that is still pretty good.
Mm-hmm. That one was pretty good.
I'd probably go 3.5 on that. Again, 3 is like, I'd eat it. A little bit better than meh. I'd say 2.5 is meh, so I'd probably go.
Yeah, I was kind of doing my scale a little different where I was trying to look at would I buy it again and take it camping. But yeah, I think that's pretty good. It's actually a pretty good flavor. So
it's got a little bit of a oaky afterbirth.
I'd say 4 for me. It's got oaky, but it's good. All right, let's try the...
You're going 4 on that?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going 3.5. That one's the chicken teriyaki.
Fettuccine Alfredo with chicken.
Hold on. That was chicken teriyaki, right?
Yep.
Okay, I'm going 3.5. Chris, you're giving it a 4.
Yep. So that one's this one. It looks like... It smells good. Looks like what we think it was. Okay. All
right.
That's pretty... I mean, that was chicken teriyaki. Pretty decent.
I love Alfredo. That's your piece. There you go. Okay, cool. So this, did you already show the picture?
I did.
This is what it should look like. Nice and constituted.
Damn, yeah.
It's good.
Yeah, dude, that's legit. I think I said that last time, huh?
Legit.
That's good. That's pretty good.
Yeah, so the thing that gets me... That's a really nice, buttery, creamy, cheesy flavor in there.
Yeah.
It tastes real.
It even tastes like aged cheese. It's got that little kick to it. It's good.
I'm trying the chicken, too. Yeah, again, the chicken has all the meat, the sausage, the chicken, the beef. The texture is not quite the same. How would you describe it? It's not necessarily chewy, but it's...
I mean, you can... I don't know.
It's almost
like
a wet, dry kind of texture, if that
makes
sense.
Yeah, you can kind of tell it's not something you'd whip out of your kitchen, but it's still like when you're hungry and you're out on the road or out camping, it's good. All right, chicken.
Wait, score. So for me, this is probably as close.
I'd say a 5 for me. It's as close.
I'm going close. I'll go 4.75 just to be a snob. All
right. Chicken fettuccine Alfredo.
All right, chicken fajita bowl. Here,
you ready? You ready to get the picture?
Yeah. All right.
Boom.
Looks like a fajita bowl. Okay.
Open. Oh, for me. Thank you.
Right off the bat. Used to talking to kids saying, open.
So this has green beans. Oh, no. What is that? That's a bell pepper? What is that? I can't tell if that's a green bean or a bell pepper.
I think it's a bell pepper.
Here's what it looks like.
Roasted peppers. That's pretty good. You could definitely put that with some tortillas. Camping.
Yeah, it's kind of got that smoke. Did it say smoked chili in there? Smoked pepper?
I think it said roasted.
Yeah,
roasted, yeah.
Yeah, you can taste that.
It's good. It's got that back of your throat spice.
Mm.
Yeah, I just had a piece of chicken that didn't concentrate all the way.
But
it's good. I like that one too. I'd say 4.5 for me. I mean, it's, or 5. It's pretty legit. I'd take it on camping.
Yeah, I would not be mad at eating that.
Chicken fajita bowl is where it's at.
That one was pretty good. You're going straight 5 on it?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, if we're looking at, like, for what it is, how good is it? I'm like, it's pretty good.
Yeah, you know, I think what pushes it up for me is that roasted pepper taste in there. That's a nice touch on it. I'll go 4.75 on that one again.
Okay.
For what it is.
Just can't commit, huh?
I can't commit, yeah.
So, Mexican style, adobo, rice, and chicken.
Let me see this one up.
Here, hit that one.
Okay. Boom. Yeah, you see those big kidney beans right there? What kind of beans are it? Pinto beans? Those are big. That's what she said. Bull. All right, here we go, Ray. Let's get a good bam. All right. And then bam.
Man, that meat constituted out really nice.
Did it?
Yeah, I mean, that's pretty big chicken in there.
Mexican style adobo rice and chicken.
Okay.
Do you get a big difference between this and the last one? Chicken fajita bowl?
It's a little different. I mean, this might be just a little bit touch drier.
That is strange. That felt more like a real, like a piece of chicken you cook at home.
Yeah. After you dried it out.
Yeah, flavor-wise, they're pretty close.
Yeah.
That's maybe a less... Unless I'm really snooty here. That's a little bit less of a complex flavor because this other one had that roasted pepper.
Mm-hmm.
But it's still good.
Yeah.
I'll go 4 on that one.
Yeah.
Where are you at?
I'm probably 3.5. Oh, still pretty legit.
Okay, so that was Mex Adobe 4. You know, now you got me second guessing myself if I went too high.
No, I mean, it's, I mean, like we talked about, for what it
for
is.
For what it is, I'm going for.
I mean, if you're
going
to try to start pitting them against each other, then yeah, that's a different story.
For what it is, for.
But for the variety of having different stuff, it's awesome.
Okay, chicken fried rice. I'm a big fan of fried rice. Looking forward to this one. Ooh, so it's got egg in there.
Yep.
And this is not as soupy. That was weird with the scrambled eggs. Maybe they're supposed to be.
Or maybe we water. Just let them sit long enough.
Yeah.
Maybe that was the minimum you're supposed to let it sit. You know, 10 minutes and we...
Yeah, but we went like 20 on it, didn't we?
Yeah, it was a while, yeah.
All right, here you go. Here.
Okay.
There. Let me get a photo for the viewers. Sorry about the gross napkin, guys. You just got to deal with it. Boom.
Okay. That's pretty good.
Is that mushroom?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, look at that. Okay, chicken fried rice. What do you think?
That's pretty good.
I mean, so first of all, it's not like the texture of what you get at a Asian restaurant. Like as far as chicken fried rice, it's a little wetter.
Right. But for a camping meal, just add water.
There was a... They actually put mushrooms in that. Here, try one of these mushrooms again, because that was a nice touch for it. That's kind of a distinct feature of that.
Mm-hmm.
Let me try that again.
And that shape, for me, it's like a 3.
I was thinking that, actually.
You know, it's not bad.
Those mushrooms are really good.
They are.
When I get a bite full of mushroom, I'm at about a 4. On the other bites, maybe a 3.
All
right. I'm going to go 3.5. I'm going 3.5. What are you going?
I'm going to say 3.
Okay, Chris is 3. I'm going 3.5. Because I'm a big fan of mushrooms.
So, what is it?
Oh,
you ready to hit
this
one?
Is one that I think I was looking forward to the most. I love pad thai. I just love Asian food. This is pad thai with chicken. So, I have been looking forward to this. Let me stir this up and then I'll give you a shot. All right. That's your shot.
Back it up a little bit.
Right there. Bam.
All right, let's do it.
a little bit of red pepper in that right there.
Sounds like you knew they had red pepper in this.
I have not tried this one yet, but I've been. This is one that I've been looking forward to the most. Hopefully, it does not disappoint. So there's the authentic way to do it. If you're from the place where this is authentic, don't be mad at me, but I think they used tamarind when they make it. It's very much kind of a vinegary, sweet, kind of sour taste. And this isn't too far off. Again, this has to be pre-made.
It's pretty good. I'd say it's another three for me, maybe 3.5. It's good.
Yeah, I figured I got my hopes up too much. The sauce is actually pretty decent. For pad thai, I'm comparing it against pad thai. I'll go 3.5 on that one.
Okay. So you. I mean, that's a high mark if you're going to say, hey, I'm comparing it now to my best restaurant food.
Okay, so Chris, you 3 on that?
Yeah. I mean, it was good, though. I mean, any one of these, if you gave me, I like them.
Yeah. So, like, if I was sitting there on a stump by a campfire, I'd be fine eating it for sure.
Yeah. So here's the lasagna with meat sauce.
Yeah, this is another one that people recommended,
which is different than spaghetti, and I don't know how.
It's different pasta.
Yeah. Yeah, but as you cut the pasta down to sizes like that, does it really change anything?
Maybe it does.
Okay, so there's little mini meatballs in here.
It definitely tastes like lasagna.
Well, that's probably what they were shooting for.
I'm thinking.
They're pretty good.
Is it better than Chef Boyardee?
Yeah. I mean, it's very tomato-y. But it's good. I like it. It's maybe a little runny for my taste. But it's an option.
Yeah, it's not very like cheesy like you'd get with the normal lasagna. I mean, it's primarily sauce and the lasagna noodle and the meat. I'm probably about a 3 on that. Where you?
Yeah, I'd say about that. All right, pasta primavera. This one looks kind of runny, but it's set for a while, so it's definitely what your vegetarian option.
So yeah, look at that. So it looks like slices of zucchini in there, some bell pepper. So yeah, that's just gonna be rotini pasta there. Yeah, once you mix it, it looks a lot better.
That does actually. It looks really creamy. Bam. All right.
Bam!
Yeah, it's actually pretty good.
All right, there's a piece of bell pepper. I want to try kind of each one of those pieces along, like the zucchini and all that. Okay, zucchini by itself.
Yep. Almost like the delivery of that's really, it was really good. I mean, I don't necessarily know if I would. I'd definitely pick it to go somewhere, but my wife likes zucchini pasta. And it's pretty good. Pretty on par.
Yeah, that's not bad.
Well, I'm going to say 4.5.
I was thinking 4, but okay, so you're 4.5?
Yeah.
That's pretty good.
Okay, so that's primavera?
Pasta primavera.
Boom.
Wow. All right, let's start for round 3.
Round 3. We're going to start out with homestyle chicken noodle casserole. Now, for me, I'm not really a big fan of casseroles generally, so I'm curious to see what this goes like. So let's mix this guy up, show you what it looks like. Looks like they use the same noodles slash pasta that they did for like the Alfredo. That's actually not looking as bad as I thought it would.
Yeah, once you kind of mix them up, I mean, even if you squeeze the bag, it doesn't really mix it like,
okay.
It doesn't really mix it like taking a spoon to it. So okay. Let's hit it. Yeah, this is already looking good.
Now, in between takes, I did sneak another bite of that Alfredo. I like good stuff. If I were to give anything a 5 for freeze-dried meals, that might be it. Now, I haven't tried these other ones, but Alfredo's pretty dang good.
That's pretty good.
Okay. Home-style chicken noodle casserole. All
right.
I'm going to try to put these over. They're not bad. I mean, except maybe a couple, maybe one or two of the breakfast ones. Any one of these you gave me, I would eat it on a camping trip. They got a good variety.
I'll go 375 on that. Yeah, I would eat it. Does it like blow me away? No, but it's pretty good.
I'll go 3, but three means I'd still, like it's a good meal.
If you haven't noticed yet, we're grading on a sliding scale here, so we'll see how it shakes out. Okay, so that one was the
homeschool, right? What was it?
That was the
homestyle chicken noodles.
Yep, homestyle chicken noodle casserole.
Chicken noodle cat. There it is. Okay.
All right, yellow curry. This one, it's all the rave.
For that too.
Yeah. All the rave. Let's see. Okay. You want to stir it?
Hold on. Wipe that off.
Whatever. Oh wait, let's not cross contaminate.
Exactly.
Right?
Do you stir it?
Let me stir it real quick. That looks pretty good, actually. Yeah, it's starting to smell like... Okay, I mean, it's like a yellow curry you'd see at Costco or something. So
see at Costco?
Yeah, you know how they sell this stuff.
Speaking of which, man, that Indian restaurant we found, that was the bomb. It was real good. All right, here we go. Maybe a little runny. I mean, curry is going to be runny, but... Might not have had
whatever. That's actually pretty good, dude. Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, that's good.
Okay. Peas, we gave them a shot, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Peas, pepper, zucchini, chicken, rice. Let's try it.
That's surprisingly good.
Way good. Great seasoning. I mean, granted, the texture is going to be a little off with the chicken, but that sauce is on point.
Dude, that's like a 5. I think I would take that. I would totally eat that. It might be a little hot coming out. I mean, it's pretty spicy, but it's good.
A little hot coming out.
It's yellow curry, man. What do you expect? With chicken rice. Yeah, that's good. Feel like you're getting a little bit of...
I'm just trying to see if I can knock it on anything. I mean, the texture, but you're going to get that with freeze-dried.
No, chicken. It's good. I definitely would buy the yellow curry. I like it. All right.
So you said 5 on that?
Yeah, I mean, if we're going to rate one of them a 5, I mean...
Okay, so I'm going to amend my pass score. I'm going 5 on the Alfredo, but I'll go... I mean, that was still really, really good. I'll go 4.75 on it.
All right.
Okay, 4.75, and you said straight up 5.
Yeah, that was good. Chicken... and dumplings. Let's try this one. This one, same kind of thing. When we
lots of people said they wanted a, that was a good one to try.
Yeah, it looked good.
Okay.
It looked like croutons. Yeah. In the, mm-hmm. It's it probably needs to be shirred again. It was a little dry in the middle, but when we can eat it and get the gist for it, but it looks pretty legit.
All right. You know what? That was pretty good yellow curry. For what it is, a freeze-dried meal that you can eat backpacking without taking a kitchen with you, I'll give it a 5.
Yeah, it was good.
Okay. That was real good.
Try that one.
Okay. So, kind of a shot inside. This is the chicken and dumplings?
Yeah.
Okay, let's get chicken and dumplings.
It already looks pretty good. For some reason, I like bread.
That's just comfort food.
Mm-hmm. That's what I was thinking.
Mm-hmm.
You're all cold and wet. It's pretty good stuff.
Yeah, you feel like you got
a little blankie on you.
Yeah, nestled in bed in front of a movie by Mama with that.
Pretty good, man. I go 4.5. But it's pretty dang good.
For chicken and dumplings? Yeah, that's really good.
I'm 4.5 too. Okay, so that one, chicken and dumplings. Okay, we'll go 4.5 on that.
creamy macaroni and cheese. Wait, well, are these paired up with the propane?
Yeah, I paired them.
Okay, so chili mac, stroganoff. Okay, cool.
Yeah. This is cheesy, holy cow.
That's cheesy. You want to strip?
I'll cleanse the palate. You.
Yeah, that's what I was doing. Well, that is definitely creamy. So this is creamy, cheesy mac.
Yeah,
that's going to be interesting. I'm curious to see what that cheese actually tastes like.
It's cheesy.
You can kind of see the texture in the cheese. So it does look saucy.
Tastes like macaroni and cheese. I mean, it's a little different than like something cooked over a stove, but
tastes like macaroni and cheese. I mean, perfect meal for
that. Macaroni is al dente.
That's perfect for a kid. I don't know if I would buy it myself for camping.
Yeah, for just plain mac and cheese, I don't know how you get much better than that.
Right, right. And I'm kind of like, when I'm grading this, I'm like, would I purchase this with my own money?
Yeah, for the kids, I think they would love it.
Yeah, that would be pretty legit. Mac and cheese. It's definitely creamy.
I'll go 3.75 on that. How about you?
Yeah, I'll go 3. I mean, it's good. I mean, I would say if we're going to use my new and improved method of scoring, 3 is really good.
Three. I thought 3 was just better than meh.
No. Meh is like
2.5.
That's yeah, 2's a meh.
2.5 is meh.
1, never purchase.
Get your story straight, man. All right, that one was creamy mac and cheese. I'm not seeing that on here. Creamy mac and cheese.
It was good. No, I'm telling you, my kids would devour that.
Is that the same as mac and cheese?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, so let's just try these. So we got, now we're into the ProPak standoffs with beef stroganoff with noodles and then the high caloric version. So let's start with
the regular.
Yeah.
I remember the last time we did this comparison, I liked the stroganoff too. It's good.
Yeah, meaty noodles is pretty good on camping.
Absolutely. Okay, let's give you a shot. Bow. Okay, where's your bowl?
There. Beef's a little gristly, or it's a little bit, it's nice. Seems like that cut for some reason didn't constitute perfectly, but I mean, it's,
I really like the mushroom flavor in there and onion. For what it is, stroganoff when you're out and about, I'm going 4.5 on that.
I'll do 4. All right, so then this is going to be, I'm assuming, the same. When we looked at these, when we're cooking them, we couldn't tell a difference between the high caloric version, the ProPaks, and then the regular. So they look the same, but I'm imagining they just change a little bit, make them a little bit more calorie dense.
Before they desecrate them?
Before they desecrate them.
Okay, that's cool.
So again, yeah.
Picking up any difference?
I'm not picking up any difference. The meat's still a little bit, it didn't completely reconstitute. But it's good. It's definitely stroganoff.
Right.
It might be just a cut.
Right. I might be playing head games with myself, but that one tasted a touch richer to me than the first
one. Maybe they put a bunch of dried butter in there or something.
Yeah, that one tasted a little bit richer. Chili Mac.
Chili Mac.
This was another one in the comments that people said, we love the Chili Mac.
So we'll start off with the regular version then.
You want to serve it?
Yeah, okay, so this is pretty runny. Wow. Did you do it right?
Did I put what it said? That is runny.
You know what? It feels, it feels a little hard too, so maybe it hasn't completely
done what I needed to. Okay, let's move on then.
Let's let me look at this one first though. Yeah, this one's a lot more. Yeah, you added too much water in that one. This one's a lot.
That might have been user error.
Smells good though. Let's taste it. Let's go ahead and do it.
All right.
Okay.
Okay, so we're gonna try to remove the watery bias.
Yeah, hit it.
Okay, just so you can see now, I'm pretty confident that we put the right amount of water in that.
Pull it back.
But after sitting here for 25 minutes or so, it's still kind of runny. And there's lots of variables there, right? We got altitude. We got controlled temperature environment. I know when I make these when I'm out camping, I like to wrap like a sweatshirt or something around these things just to hold in heat a little bit more while they cook instead of just leaving them open to the wind blowing that heat off. Yeah, that pasta's still a little firm.
It's good though. I like that with the beef better than just, you know, plain.
Definitely a good amount of chili powder in there. It's chili.
Let's see if we can taste the difference. You ready? I don't think we're gonna be able to tell.
I don't know if I got any beans in my.
I'm trying to fatten you up.
Yeah, exactly.
Is that a little more spicy? This one tastes a little more spicy.
It's pretty heavy on the chili powder, but yeah, it's a lot better when it's all that we constitute like that.
But I'd say both about the same in flavor. For probably a 3. I mean, it's what it is. It's going to be hard for me to, like, if I was going back and picking individual ones, to pick some of these over others, I'd just probably grab my favorites and eat them a bunch of times.
Yeah. Yeah, it is what it is. Like you said, I'll go 3.5. Well, 3.25 on that one.
Okay, so that was Chili Mac. Are you giving them both the same score?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, so we're going rice and chicken. Yeah, this looks... So it's got its pro-pack version, too.
So let's stir this one up.
Yeah, this one constituted nice. It turned out good. So if you look at it,
it looks good. Let's
try that one.
Smaller for me, please. There you go.
Trying to get every little
piece. Yeah, exactly.
Every little piece off.
That's just more of that comfort food.
It's good though.
Yeah. I definitely like the seasoned ones more. But for just rice and chicken.
Yeah, I'll go 3.25 on that. Where are you at?
3. 3?
Yeah,
that's good. That's good.
Pro pack?
Yeah, this is the pro pack. I can't really tell a difference.
Is there a pro pack and, wait, was there, this has red bell pepper. Did that one have red bell pepper in it?
No.
You want to check inside? Or is that carrot?
No, it does. It does.
It does, and carrot? Okay. Mm-hmm.
It's the same.
Whoa!
It's spicy?
Whoa! Mm-mm. All right. Let me get a piece of chicken out of that one. The chicken in this was good.
Oh, yeah.
Did you get a piece of that?
Mm-hmm. It could have just been batches.
Yeah, I'm trying a piece of chicken from the other one.
That pro-pack was way
better.
Way better. That already feels like it's pretty filling, huh?
That might have been the biggest difference I tasted between the pro-pack and the
the regular.
Oh, whatever cut that was, it's pretty good. It's got a nice flavor, too.
Yeah, that one. That was a big jump. I'd probably go 4 on that.
Yeah, I'll say 4 and then 3 on the other one.
Okay, so that was the rice.
Okay, what do we got next?
Spaghetti. Classic spaghetti with meat sauce. And we got the...
What are we finishing with, though? The mashed potatoes?
The mashed potatoes, and we'll talk about that one in a sec. So... Yep, this one... Yeah, it's definitely different than the lasagna. You got the little spaghetti pieces.
It's going to be the same stuff, though, probably. Sauce and everything.
Get you a
little... Ooh, ah. Bigger tomato chunks on this, though.
Yeah.
At least from what I can tell. Do we still have the lasagna down here?
Mm-mm.
That tastes different.
It does.
It's sweeter.
Yeah.
I actually like that. That's pretty good.
Yeah.
I'll go 4 on that.
I mean, they're both good. I mean, I remember the lasagna was pretty good. But yeah, it's a little bit sweeter of a taste. It's got more of a,
yeah,
like a sugary.
Both of us gave lasagna a 3. I think I'd go 4 on that for me.
Okay.
Where are you at?
Yeah, probably 4. It's pretty good. So, I mean, I didn't show, I don't think I showed the other one, but they're right the same.
Looks like,
no. Noodles.
Oh, and the next one's a Pro Pack. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Right. Yeah, this one doesn't seem as red. It's more of a brown sauce.
Interesting. Oh, yeah. I wonder if we can actually pick that up. Where's the other one?
Yeah, that's definitely not as sweet. So it's a little different.
A little spicy. That's the biggest taste difference.
Yeah.
This is a deeper flavor.
Mm-hmm. Well, what do you like better? Would you rather eat? I mean, you are going to put on 50 calories.
They're both good. They're both good.
Yeah, they're both good.
They taste different, but I would give them both 4. They're good.
Yeah, they're both good.
Okay.
So I guess the Pro Pack is, if you want to go out and be a pro... There you go.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so
wait, you're 4 on that one too?
Yeah, they're both really good.
Okay.
So this one was the only one, the chicken mashed potato dinner. Chicken and mashed potatoes. It's the only one that was a little different. So it had the oxygen absorber, and then it also had another mashed, it looks like freeze-dried mashed potatoes or mashed potatoes that you would buy at a store. Insta potatoes. So that was in a separate pack. You pulled that out, you put the water in with the chicken. Let it sit, then you poured that in about 5 minutes later and then stirred it up. So
it's basically mashed potatoes with chicken mixed in.
Yeah.
I'm going to give you a shot of this. Here, I'll scoop it in. Show them. Bam.
Yep. Yeah, that's definitely instant mashed potatoes, but
there you go.
Okay. So I guess with this meal, you got a lot of chicken in it, right? But it just tastes like...
You
I mean, you get 43 grams of protein, so that's a lot of protein.
That might be the blandest one we've had, maybe outside. Well, for the entrees, yeah, but I think the only one down there would be the just the scrambled eggs.
I'm looking at it, though. You're looking at
10 to 20 grams more protein with this, so that's probably the big thing. With
no
it.
Kidding.
Yeah.
That's just protein laden.
Yeah, because, I mean, you had all that chicken in there. Flavor-wise,
I'd go 2.5 on that. That's enough for me.
It's probably a 2 for me. It's not very a buttery mashed potato, and I've had some pretty good instant mashed potatoes before. But I mean, if you want high protein, there that's probably your best option.
Hey, did we do a spicy sweet skillet?
Yeah, it's at breakfast.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. All right. So there we go. That's every meal that we had to cook.
But we're not done.
We are not done.
We're not done. We're going to try the ice cream sandwiches. Let us get resituated, and then we'll rejoin you. So we ran the numbers on our very scientific test here with the huge sample set of 2. And based on what we liked, we did the average on everything. We both ranked fettuccine Alfredo and yellow curry the same. They both got 5s all the way across. However, I just had some more of that yellow curry, and I might have to say, just compared against one another, that curry's pretty good.
That is pretty good.
I might have to put that right top.
That's good. Yeah. I mean, it was legit.
It was pretty good. Okay, so yeah. Fettuccine Alfredo and curry right there neck and neck at the top. Chicken fajita bowl came in, well, third after the Thai. Chicken and dumplings then came in fourth. And then biscuits and gravy. Biscuits and gravy was the breakfast one. Yeah. So that was just good. I mean, it just was... You feel like it sticks to your ribs and that'll last you for a while and you go out and eat. And no, it's comfort.
Comfort food.
Okay, last up. We're going to try these sandwiches. Now, we do not have to...
Yeah, so with these, they're ready to eat. You just open them up and you eat them. They're freeze-dried, but you don't got to reconstitute them.
Bon appetit.
Oh, wow. We're wrapped just like a real one.
I feel like I'm holding one of those wafer bars.
It does seem wafery. You know what? It's probably just a straight up ice cream. Yeah, I mean, I'm imagining it's just an ice cream sandwich that they just freeze dried.
Okay, I want that. Yeah, I want some of that. Here. I'll be a little more civilized. Mint chocolate chip. Anybody get that reference? Throw it in the comments below.
Yeah, it's just an ice cream sandwich that's been freeze dried.
Not bad. That's the crunchiest ice cream I've ever had.
It's good. Not bad.
All right. Okay. So remember, use that coupon code. We got it down in the description. Order this stuff. Try to get. And this is straight, candid, honest direction and recommendations. You should probably have, if you can swing it, a week's worth of this or more for each member in your family. I feel comfortable saying that. I don't feel like I'm reaching when I say that.
No.
Okay. Again, if you're more of a homesteader or prepper, you're going to have lots of other ways to create and store food, whether you're doing canning or dehydrating or whatever. But again, emergency situation, you want to throw it in your back and run. These are awesome for them. Big thank you to Mountain House. We loved the opportunity to do this example because I know for me, I would love seeing this video to basically get, you know, to vicariously taste test through somebody else and know maybe what I wanted to buy and what I didn't. You want to add anything?
That's it. I got it.
You got it?
I got it, man.
Okay. Well, thanks for joining us. Hope it was helpful. And until next time, in Omnia Paratus.